So, Josh, welcome to Swansea City. You must be delighted to be here.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Yeah, really, really excited to be here. I'm really looking forward to and to getting on with things. So, all good.
And what was it about this club that made it the right move for you at this time?
I think for me, there's a real strong identity here at the club in terms of how the club tries to do things, in terms of the head coaches that it's had over the years, the style of play. And the club's been successful as well in terms of obviously a good stint in the Premier League. So I think those things combined and sort of knowing and getting to know a few people that are obviously in sort of prominent positions here, that gave me a strong feeling this was a really good opportunity for myself.
I was going to ask you about the Swansea way, as it's referred to, because obviously you mentioned there, it's come back in force over the last year with the way that Russell Martin, the head coach, wants to play.
Yeah.
And I was going to ask you if that was made it easier or more difficult, but it seems to be something that's actually drawn you to the club.
Yeah, I think it's a real positive. I think, if you talk about player recruitment specifically against that, I think having a clear identity really helps. I think that was something that very much was a positive for me, and also aligns to my beliefs in terms of how I like to watch a game be played and the type of players that I like, etc. That was a real positive.
So you're here as head of football operations. Within British football, that's a fairly new kind of role. How do you view that role and where your kind of position will sit within the club?
I think it can differ from club to club. I've been fortunate. I've worked at three different clubs now, and it's been different at each club. So I think here specifically, my role will be to oversee the football departments, and work really closely with Julian and Russell. And try and be that sort of link between everything and bring everything together. I think you're right in what you say. I think it's evolved. It's evolved a lot in recent times. The role and more clubs now are implementing it.
You mentioned Russell and Julian there. They're obviously people you'd be working with really closely. What conversations have you had with them so far?
So Julian, I'd previously worked with at Huddersfield. Enjoyed my time working with him. Felt like we worked well together. I feel like I have an understanding for what he wants in this role, which is important. Then naturally throughout the process, I was introduced to Russell. Spent a good amount of time speaking with him, I was just really, really infused by the conversation. He's full of energy, full of enthusiasm. Really strong in his beliefs on how he sees the game, which is infectious, which I really took to, and also I think came across as a really good person as well, which is important. Really looking forward to working with him.
And in terms of football operations and head coach, how does that kind of relationship work from your point of view?
Yeah, I think it's important that you work together. But I think it's important you have a relationship where you can be open and honest with each other, to challenge each other, to maybe have a different view to each other, but have that conversation and it's always for the benefit of the club, whether that be short, medium, long term. I think that from my experience of seeing the best sort of relationships between those two people in those respective roles, they're very much, they're open, they're honest with each other, they speak, relentlessly day to day, and have that real understanding for each other and respect of what each person is ultimately responsible for. That's how I'd see it.
And you mentioned Huddersfield, that's the club you've just come from. You had a sort of a head of recruitment kind of role there.
Yeah.
How big a part will recruitment play in your role here at Swansea?
Yeah, huge. I think naturally that's my background is scouting and recruitment. I think from my conversations with the club, they see that as a big part of this role and overseeing that. I think that my knowledge and experience within that field is something that I want to bring to this role and will be a part of a part of what I try and do and try and put in place.
And you've worked within League One, Championship, the Premier League with with Huddersfield as well. So you must have a really good knowledge of the kind of the pool of players that are out there and the talent that's available, I guess.
Yeah, exactly. I feel lucky to have worked at those respective levels. You know, as you said, League One, Championship, Premier League, and the time that I was at Southampton, sort of the top end of or top half of the Premier League and competing in Europe. So it's been great to sort of experience the game at those respective levels and what it takes to compete at those levels, and then naturally sort of your knowledge of players and how you need to be set up from an infrastructure point of view. And so yeah, I think that puts me in really good stead for this opportunity, and hopefully the journey will go on at the club. So
there's a lot of talk at this club about bringing in players who will then become assets either on the pitch or possibly in the transfer market. Somebody that will stand out at Huddersfield to followers of Welsh football will be Sorber Thomas, who's obviously come out of non-league and is now performing really well in the Championship.
Yeah.
How important is it to bring those kind of players to this club to spot those kind of players, I guess?
Yeah, I think really important. I think, again, from my conversations with the club throughout this process, that sort of principle of trading and trying to be proactive with that, and you know, think outside the box and not just sort of, you know, do sort of normal Championship transfer activity, I think is something that the club are passionate about and believe in, and again that aligns to sort of my belief. So yeah, I think you've got a few things on that. Obviously, there's identifying the talent. There's then being brave and being proactive and being sort of in terms of your decision making and then getting that backed internally to go and bring the player in. And then also when the player comes in, it's like, what does that look like? How are you set up in terms of the club to basically help that player in terms of his transition through to ultimately where you want him to get to? And I think, you know, Sorber is a great example of that, where I feel that the club really got that right in terms of, you know, the expectation in terms of how quickly he was going to be a prominent player in the first team was correct. You know, he came in, he had 6 months with the B team, integrated in terms of our methods, the level of everything. You know, obviously, was with all due respect, there's a big jump from National League to Championship, and then the following pre-season he comes in and then flies and has obviously had a really positive season. So yeah, I think there's the identification, there's then the recruitment piece, then also how you set up in terms of across all the departments and the support that you give the player when he's in the building.
And as well as bringing in players from outside, like you've talked about there, Swansea has an academy that's produced a lot of talent in the past. How important will that be or the academy pathway be to recruitment and the first team this year?
Yeah, massive, yeah. I think, like you said, there's a good history of success in that area at the club. And yeah, I think it's... I think for the model that the club wants in place in terms of the squad and how that looks, it's imperative that young players, you know, do get through. And again, I think, you know, the same principles that I spoke about in terms of Sorber, I think, you know, you have to, you know, you've got to get your identification, your recruitment right, but then you've got to have the right things in place across all the departments to develop players. And then also, you know, in terms of, you know, my conversations and the decision making with Julian, with Russell, you've also got to provide opportunity. You know, you can't block pathways, and so I think it's just a balance of all those things and getting it right. But I think it has to be a big part of what we do here going forwards.
There's a lot of talk about last season being transitional, and you could see that, you know, it sort of improvement as it went along. There's quite a lot of positivity going into the new season that we can build on a sort of stronger end to the season. How much are you relishing the opportunity? You know, this could be a big time, a big transfer window for the club. How much are you relishing the opportunity that's ahead of you?
Yeah, no, I think you're right in what you're saying. I think last season, you know, obviously Russell has had that period of time now at the club and with his team, and the players and the staff will now be sort of immersed within that and have an understanding for what both Russell and his team, you know, want in place. So I think that puts the team in a really good place going into next season and going into the summer. So I think it's just looking at the group and trying to identify some key sort of things that you know we can try and help improve going into next season. So yeah, I think it's a really exciting time to sort of come on board, you know, having that's already taken place in terms of that initial adaptation to Russell's ideas, and then and then go again for next season and try and move forwards.
We've talked sort of about the immediate project and where you're going to kind of start off, I guess, but in terms of longer term project, in terms of your role and in terms of the club in general, what's the kind of longer term vision, I guess?
Yeah, I think it's to be successful, you know. I think short, medium, long term, I think that's my responsibility to try and drive that, working with Julian, working with Russell, working with the owners, but to do that in a sustainable and a structured way that sort of aligns with the identity of how the club likes to work and to do things. But yeah, again, in the conversations, you know, it's not a case of, you know, I could sense a real desire for the club to be successful and to move forwards. And, you know, naturally, obviously that involves the, you know, getting back to the Premier League and then trying to stay in the Premier League. But again, it's also doing that in the right way, in a sustainable way, in a structured way that sort of aligns to how the club, you know, the club's beliefs and how it wants to do things. So
before we started, you were just saying that this wasn't actually your first visit to the Swansea.com stadium. Do you want to tell us you've been here before?
Yeah, I've been here a few times, but I was actually here as a player once. I was a youth team player at Wrexham, and we played in a youth cup final here. I think it was 2009. So yeah, I visited the stadium, and I remember it was a really big moment because as a youth team player, we didn't play in stadiums, and we certainly didn't play in stadiums like this. So it was a really exciting day. I remember just being sort of amazed by the experience, you know, being on the pitch. And so yeah, no, it was it's a special memory of mine. And obviously, when this opportunity came about, it straight away sort of jogged in my mind. So now it's great to be back, and obviously great to be back in this capacity, in this role now. And unfortunately, I wasn't quite good enough to make it as a professional player. So good memories.
Next best thing to working for.
Yeah, exactly.
It's brilliant. Thank you so much.
Thank you.